Good morning, everyone. What a blessed morning. We thank God for keeping us safe throughout the entire weekend and also helping us to sleep well and wake up this morning energized and ready to face the day and a new week. Today we are going to have a special communion session, and God is going to heal us of all diseases and all impediments in our life. He's going to take all of them out, and God is going to restore back to us good health and miracles and signs and wonders. That job you are looking for is going to come your way today as we take the communion. And if you have any sick folks at home or in the hospital, I want you to stand in the gap for them as you take the communion this morning. Write down their name and just put it by you, and the healing power of God is going to touch them as my father, Bishop Dagiwa Mills, prays for them. I want you to quickly invite your family and friends to join in this morning. And kindly share this quiet time on your timeline so that it will be a blessing to many people out there. And as you do this, I want you to pray in tongues for just the next few minutes and charge yourself up for the day. Let's do that right away. Yanderebo sekenderebo shandaraba yandarabo sendereve konderebo shatalawadarababa. Ima ma sindere we kondere bo sha tele we dore bo sindara wa kendere bo shondere we dore be. Ima ma sandara wa kandara bo shindere we kondere bo sandara wa dara baba. Ima ba kendere bo shondere we dere bo zindara wa dere bo shintere we dore be. Ima ma sondere we kondere bo shondere we adara ba zindara wa dara baba. Ima be kendere bo shoketere we dere bo sindere we dore bo. Ima mandala vadala ba zita la va kondere bo shendere vedere be. Ima basandala vadala bo zita la va kondere bo sendara vadore bo shendere vedere be. Ima besa dele ve kondara bo shi kandere ve dore ba sindere ve kondere bo shata la vadala ba be. Ima bo zendere ve kondara bo shi kandere bo dore bo zita la va kondere bo shendere vedere be. Ime beso televe, katere bo shindale ve kondere bo sata la vadara bo shit ala vedere be. Imo sandele ve komba hidare ve kondere bo shandele ve kopa hala vadara bo sita la vadara ba. Ima bo zindele ve kondere bo shota la vado, diri vi kotele bo zika tele bo shombare barat. Ime done ve komba dendare bo sike tele bo shit ala vendore boda. Ima done va diri bo kot eleve, dare bo sit ala ve kondare bo shandere ve. Mia dere vendore bo sit ala ve ko barize ve kot ele bo shandere ve. Ima be dara va dore bo zike tere ve shomba de indara ba di dare ve. Kon diri bo se tere ve shomba de andiri ve. Ime don dere ve, kon dere mo sin dare ve, kon dare bo shatara va dare bo kondara va di indara ba andara ba. Mezon dele ve kombale ve subare ke tere vo shent alavandere be. Vikat ele ve so bahe ke tiri vo zima bo dere ve. Mekondere ve shundere ve kombale va so mare ke tere vo shandere be. Ima dana vandare ma si ke tere vo ju tere ve do dara bare. E kondela vandore ma si tala va kondere mo shundere ve dere bo. Ima bendara vandara mama ze kendere mo shundere ve kombale mia dara va. Ima konta la vadara mo, si ke tere vo shondere me kondere bo jinda la vadara bar. Ibo se tere ve ko bare bo si ke ndere vo shotere vedere be. Dear Lord, we honor you this morning. We thank you so much for being who you are to us, for being ever faithful, for being trustworthy. We rely on you, O Lord, our dependable God. You who blesses and you add no sorrow. You are our Jehovah Rapha, the Lord our healer. Our peace, Jehovah Shalom. We honor you this morning, O Lord. We give you all the praise, all the glory for all that you have done for us and about to do for us. We thank you, O Lord, that you see the end from the beginning. Therefore, we put our trust in you. We thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit. Good morning, one more time. My name is Pastor Mrs. Engineer John Bright. I bring you the quiet time written by my father, Bishop Doug Heward Mills, on behalf of my pastor, my counselor, the love of my life, my husband, the one and only living mandate, Reverend Peter Bright Sr. He extends his love to you this morning. If you haven't prepared your communion down already, I want you to quickly do that. Prepare your communion down because the healing power of God is going to touch you this morning. And there are going to be amazing signs and wonders, miracles that are going to come your way as Bishop Doug Heward Mills prays for us. So I want you to do that. Prepare your communion down before we look into the Word of God this morning. I want you to do that with great expectation. And I want us to turn our Bibles to Luke chapter 14. We are going to be looking at the topic stay. We're going to look at the topic stay. Stay at the place where God has placed you. Do not leave, but stay. That is the word of God to you and I this morning. We are to stay. So we're going to look at a brief story in Luke chapter 14, verse 25 to 30. Luke 14, verse 25 to 30. I read the King James Version. It says that, "And there went great multitudes with him, and he turned and said unto them, If any man come to me and hate not his father and mother and wife and children and brethren and sisters, yea, and his own life also, he cannot be my disciple." The scripture is very clear. If you want to be a disciple of God, this is Jesus speaking right here. A lot of people do not like to read the scripture, but it is in the Bible. If you believed all other scriptures, you have to believe this one too. Jesus is saying that if you want to become my disciple, then you have to hate your mother, hate your father, hate your wife, hate your children, your brothers and sisters, and even hate your own life also. What is Jesus saying in effect? It means that you have to be ready to abandon it all. You must not love anything more than Jesus. Jesus must be the number one love of your life. You must love Jesus above anything else. You must love Jesus even more than you love yourself. It is only when you get to that point that you can be able to be his disciple. If you love anything else more than Jesus, you cannot be his disciple. Remember, God is a jealous God. He wants us to set our love on him. We have to love Jesus more than we love ourselves, more than we love our mothers, our fathers. Therefore, when you are taking a decision that is going against and you have oppositions from your family, that must not worry you. Once you know God has called you and you are sure about it, you go for it. Your family will come along the way. They will come along later. God will work on them. And if you do not have any opposition for you to fight and to stick to Jesus, then what really shows that you really love God? God didn't say that everything was going to be rosy when you come to Him. No, it is a fight. You must be ready to fight, to stay in the call and stay where God has placed you. Verse 27, and whosoever doeth not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. What is the cross? The cross is like maybe you have an issue in life. Probably you do not have a job and you are still expected to still fulfill your cause, to still be in church. You do not have money. That is your cross at that moment. But you have to be able to carry that cross and still serve God despite. You may not be feeling well, but you still have to be able to preach. That is the cross you have to bear. So Jesus is saying that unless you get to that point where you can bear your cross and still do what I've asked you to do, you cannot be my disciple. Verse 28, for which of you, intending to build a tower, seated not down first and counted the cost, whether he have sufficient to finish it? Lest haply, after he had laid the foundation and is not able to finish it, all that behold it begin to mock him, saying, this man began to build and was not able to finish. Therefore, before you go into ministry, before you do anything, you initiate in doing anything for God, you have to count the cost and be willing to know what you are going to sacrifice and be willing to pay the price. For example, I have to pay the price of loneliness, being alone sometimes, because I'm married to a traveling minister, as some call it. And we cannot travel together all the time. He's away 80% of the year. So what do? Do you live a miserable life because you are married to someone like that? No. You also have to be happy. You have to decide to be happy and fulfill your role as his helpmate. And that is what I do. That is the price I have to pay. People are always amazed at how happy I am, even though my husband is not around all the time or we are not together all the time. God is the joy of my life. His joy gives me strength to continue and to move on. So that is the cross I have to pay. There is a cross you have to also carry. There is a price you also have to pay. Everything is not going to be perfect before you serve God. It doesn't work like that. You may find yourself in a church and under your pastor, and things may not be going the way you want it to be. But all of that is helping to train you and to shape you. You do not have to leave. It is cowards who leave. It's cowards who give up. It's cowards who back down. Courageous people stay where God has put them to be. They stay where God has asked them to stay. And eventually they flourish. So stay where God has put you. Do not leave. Do not back down. Ecclesiastes 7 verse 8. Ecclesiastes chapter 7 verse 8 says that better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. The end of a thing is better than the beginning. And the patient in spirit is better than the proud in spirit. So if only you are patient in spirit, you are patient, you see the glory that is at the end of what you are going through. Better is the end of a thing than the beginning. So the beginning of it is always stressful. You struggled a lot and all that. But the end of it is glorious. You do not have to give up just because things are difficult. Go through it. Carry the cross. Bear your cross. Go through it. Fix your affection on God. looking unto Jesus, the author, not looking unto man, not looking unto anything else, not looking at your circumstance, but looking unto Jesus. That's in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. Looking unto Jesus, you keep your focus on Jesus, who is the author and finisher of our faith. Jesus himself had to stay focused to be able to die for you and I on the cross. Verse 3 says that, for he endured the cross, despising the shame. Even Jesus had to remain focused. How much more you and I, his disciples, we also have to remain focused. We look up to Jesus and stay where God has asked us to stay. My father, Bishop Dahiwa Mills, says that there are three main things that will test everyone's loyalty. Three main things. That is the test of distance, the test of time, and the test of fire. If you pass these tests, then your loyalty is real. If you pass all these three tests, then your loyalty is real. There is the test of distance. Paul had to exhort a branch of his church in Galatia to stay faithful, even though he was not physically present with them. In Galatians 4:18, he says that, but it is good to be zealously affected, always in a good thing, not only when I am present with you. So you do not have to do eye service. It is not about eye service. You have to be faithful no matter what. No matter, even if your pastor is not physically there, even if your boss is not there, remain faithful, do the right thing. Do not change the figures just because you are not being watched. God is watching you. You have to pass the test of distance. Many companies do not work efficiently unless the manager is physically present. No, you do not have to become disloyal just because your manager is not physically around. Remain faithful. Be a good Christian. Time is yet another test of loyalty. Time will test our resolve to stay loyal to our words. Time. How much longer will you last in the ministry? How much longer will you preach the things God told you to preach? How much more time has to elapse before you rebel against your leader? Are you going to be an early leaver, a late leaver, or will you stay until the end? Time will tell. We all have to pass the test of time. The fact that you are loyal today doesn't mean you'll be loyal tomorrow. You have to keep at it and remain focused. Now, fire represents all kinds of pressures that will come against you. Fire, it represents the pressures that will come against you. When you work in an organization, a transfer or an instruction you do not like could be a test. A transfer, when you are transferred, or an instruction that is given that you do not like. Could be the fire that you are facing. Fire could also be spiritual, social, marital, or financial. Those who come out of the fire unscathed are most valuable to God. This test should not make you disloyal to your God. This test should not make you to become disloyal to your God. God often puts the heat on his servants in order to bring the best out of them. I read that again. God often puts the heat on his servants in order to bring the best out of them. Malachi chapter 3 verse 3. When he shall sit as a refiner and purifier of silver, and he shall purify the sons of Levi and purge them as gold and silver, that they may offer unto the Lord an offering in righteousness. So God himself sometimes puts us through certain pressures, certain fires, just to purify us. Purify us and make us better. Make us more worthy vessels in his hands that he can use. So do not give up in the face of that pressure you are facing right now. God himself is with you. He wants you to pass the test so that he will make you a better person, so that he can elevate you and promote you. Tell yourself, I am going to pass this test. And you can pass this test. 1 Corinthians 10:13, there is no temptation that comes to us that is above us. But God gives everyone the temptation that he or she can handle. And even in the temptation, he makes a way of escape. You can overcome this. You can. Rather pray for grace to be able to go through it. God told Paul when he had a thorn in his flesh, he prayed to God 3 times, and God told him that my grace is sufficient for you. Ask God for grace to be able to go through that which you need to go through. You can overcome this. You can overcome this test. When you have passed through the test, you will shine and become more attractive. Decide to be a survivor. Develop staying power. Be loyal to God until your very last breath. Be loyal to God until your very last breath. Be loyal to your pastor and to your church until the end. Be loyal to the very end. Do not back out. Do not give up. Remember, it is only cowards who do that. Only cowards give up just at the break of a blessing. Stay where God has put you. God will grant you the grace to be able to overcome. He will. In Jesus' name. Why don't you bow down your heads with me? Let's say a quick prayer. Dear Lord, we come before you this morning and we pray, oh Lord, for grace. Grace to be able to go through that which we have to go through. Grant us great grace to remain faithful and loyal to the very end in the name of Jesus. Amen. Now we are going to take our communion. And if you have any sick folks, I want you to stand in the gap for them and believe God, that God himself will touch them, as my father Bishop Dakiwa Mills prays for us this morning. And whatever you are believing God for, as you take the communion, believe it. Believe it. Believe that you have received it and you will receive it. Believe it. And you will receive it.
Brothers, sisters, we are one.
Ready with my communion. I hope you are ready with yours as well.
Eat his body, drink his blood, and we'll sing a song of love. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Father, thank you for the body.
Yes, Lord.
Of Jesus Christ. We receive life.
Yes, Father.
We receive you into our lives. And we receive ourselves into you as well. You dwell in us and we dwell in you as we partake of your body and of your blood. Yes. The body of Jesus Christ.
The body of Jesus Christ.
and out the blood. How many have made a mistake before? That's what the blood is for. He says, I will blot out your sins and your transgressions as far as the east is from the west. Today, every mistake that is fighting you, by the blood of the Lamb, it is blotted out. Every wrong thing you said, that has been repeated to you over and over, is blotted out by the blood. Every mistake you've made in your life is canceled out by the blood of Jesus Christ. When I see the blood, I will pass over. May you escape all threats, all attacks, all wickedness against your life through the blood of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross.
Yes.
The emblem of suffering and shame.
No movement at all.
And I love that old cross where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain.
So I'll cherish.
So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down.
Oh, I will cling.
I will cling to the old rugged cross.
For your blessing. Jesus, look on your little children and help them. Help them to stand. Help them not to fall. Help them to be on a rock. To stay. You are lifted at this moment out of every miry clay. And your feet are washed. And you are placed upon a rock. Father, lift your children up into the heights of the clouds, higher than they imagine, where they never thought they could be. Let them stand there by prophetic power, supernatural power, superior power. Let there be an elevation. 2 weeks from now, 2 months from now, and 2 years from now, you'll be turned into a greater light. The light that is coming out of you is being magnified by the power of the Lord. In 3 stages, you will see it coming to pass practically. Receive the hand of the Lord upon your life. Somebody here has been given a horse. The horse will make you go faster. Receive your spiritual horse in the name of Jesus. You are going faster and faster to where you are destined to be in the name of Jesus. Whatever slows you down has been overcome today in Jesus' name. Whatever makes you trip has been overcome today in Jesus' name. Whatever makes you stumble is overcome today in Jesus' name. The blessing of the Lord is upon you. Those who have mocked you, those who have mocked you and laughed at you, will turn into those who are celebrating you in Jesus' name. Whatever is shameful in your life, God turns it around today in Jesus' name. By the blood of the Lamb, you are prevailing and you are moving to higher heights in Jesus' name. Place your hand on your chest. Father, I pray for healing. Whatever pain, whatever sickness, whatever plague, whatever disease, whatever diagnosis, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. Go now, go now, go now. In Jesus' name, be healed. Be healed of every mysterious diagnosis of the enemy. Your long-awaited answer comes to you now in Jesus' name. Your long-awaited breakthrough comes to you now in the name of Jesus. Amen. Receive a lifting up of the Lord, a healing power of God into your life in Jesus' name. You are declared a great child, a great person, a person with the blessing of the Lord upon your life. Lift your hand and give thanks to God for his power. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Wow, what an awesome, awesome prayer. The long-awaited breakthrough has come. Your healing has come. Believe it and walk in it. It is real. It is real. We are already out of time, but I want to quickly introduce these books to you. I want you to get the whole loyalty series. Get the Makarios. And these are the first 7 books in the Makarios, okay? Because we are out of time, I cannot go through them all, but grab all of these books in the Loyalty Series. It will help you to develop your staying power. It will help you to stay where God has placed you. And also get the Mantano. The Mantano is 11 textbooks, powerful textbooks written by my father. And grab this one, the Leader's Manual on Loyalty and Disloyalty. It will be a blessing to you. It will help you. Once you learn it and you know the dynamics of loyalty and disloyalty, you'll be able to stay where God has placed you. Get this book. Call any of the numbers scrolling on your screen and get them. Visit www.darkywardmills.org. Click on the worldwide offices. Click on your country and you see the number to contact to get the Makarios and the Mantano. God bless you for joining in. Walk in your healing. Walk in your breakthrough. Remember, you are a daughter and a son of the Most High God, who created the whole world and everyone in it. Therefore, you are a victor and not a victim. God bless you for joining in. I'll see you tomorrow by the grace of God at 6:30 GMT plus 1. Have a blessed day. Bye.